So, back with the Pi Pico W web server today. I'm not really going to be controlling any of these LEDs on this today, but I decided I would have a look at trying to serve images off the Pico. So far, we've got Bootstrap working on it. We've got individual CSS files built into the code and also a CSS file on the file system. So theoretically, it should be easy to convert what I did for the CSS files into something that serves images. On this Pico, I've got this webroot directory, and this is where I can, if I want, serve the CSS files from. And I've also put a couple of images on there as well, which is what I want to serve on this little web control page that I've got. This is all working, but you notice there's a little broken image tab in there. So all I did was, in the HTML for the page, I just added this image source equals, and actually it doesn't need to be avatar, it needs to be avatar small, which is the file that I've got on there. So if you watch the other video on CSS, you realize that in the actual server, in fact, let's turn off the files. So you'll note that in the actual server, I've got something that looks for a .css in the file request that comes through. So obviously, if I want to do a different image, such as the ping files, which I've got on there, I've got to look for something else. Now, I could replicate this and create another one that looks specifically for ping files. I'd have to do that for every image file, like a GIF file or a JPEG file. But I'm not going to do this because this is just a proof of concept. And actually, there's probably someone's written a much better web server for this that does serve things off the file store properly. But I think there are some caveats with the images. Is putting images on the Pi a good thing? I don't know. So all I'm going to do on this occasion is just modify this code so that it doesn't serve a CSS anymore. It serves as a ping. So I'm not going to change a lot of things. I'm just going to say, look for a PNG file. Simple as that. So it's looking for .png in the file request. And up here, the file is avatar small ping, so .png. So let's stop and start that web server and refresh it and see if we can get that image to appear and see what happens. Few things happen there when I hit refresh. Notice that this is still spinning, because it's still waiting for the Pi to respond with an image. And over here, we're getting a different error. We're getting a memory allocation failed, allocating 52,000 bytes. So it looks like there's a limit on at least this code that I've done, the file size that we can serve. It might be that we could serve the file in chunks, but this server setup won't do that in this current state. Probably the best thing to do just to see if this will work is to use a smaller file. That's why there were two files on my file store. So let's go back into that again. Let's look at the files again. See, and in the webroot, I put a second file, which is avatar SpiderMaf 120 pixels, I think it's called. So let's change that to avatar SpiderMaf. And I loaded this previous ping file into an image editor and made it a little bit smaller, well, a lot smaller actually. So 120 pix, I think it was called. Just check. Yeah, 120 px. So stop and start and see if that gets rid of the memory error. So hit refresh. All right, so we've now got something working. So the ping file is there. In fact, the image file is there. Hang on, I wasn't expecting that to work. Okay, so we've got an image file there. There's a little bit of something going on at the bottom. That could be CSS styling, it might be something else, but we'll come back to that in a minute. But that actually has gone straight through. So even though that image is served with the wrong MIME type, because it's still served with the CSS MIME type, this code has just sent it through. And the browser obviously has worked out it's a ping file. So what I was expecting that I would have had to do is here do image ping there, which if we go to a list of MIME types, you see that's an example MIME type for an image. So maybe I just had something in the cache there. but that will actually do that correctly. Now, it still says CSS there and CSS requested, but remember, all I've done is just change this code, so instead of looking for a CSS file, it looks for a ping file. The rest of this will still work the same way. We don't have to worry about that, really. This is just a proof of concept. So that concept works, but we've got this little bit of image clipping at the bottom. Now, originally I thought, oh, let's do some bootstrap styling on that, but that's not going to be the case, because if we take the URL that we're requesting, so I'll just grab that from there and paste it after the IP address there. So this now shouldn't try and serve the HTML at all. It should just show the image. Whoops. So this is the problem that I was saying. If I'm looking at the image, it now doesn't know that's an image because of this. So I made that image ping. Let's just start it and stop it and run it again and re-request that. And now I've got an image come through. But there's the issue. See, the bottom of the image is corrupted. Now, when I put that image on the Pico, that image was the full circle, my SpiderMaf avatar, and it's being cut off there for some reason by the Pico code. So I think this is just because there's either a memory error in the Pico, it's not able to hold it. If you see what this does, when it looks for this file name, which would be the image at this point, it opens the requested file and puts it in this response object. And what I think is happening is that response object isn't big enough to hold all the image. So it might be that it's possible, as I said, to page that. Not something I'm going to get into in this video. It might not even work, and it's a bit beyond me. This just proves that you can use the Pico to serve images, but you have to be real careful how big those images are, because this code, which is basically a hacked version of the demo code that we're given, isn't capable in itself of sending big images through. So I hope you found that interesting. Just a little show and tell, really, about whether this can serve images. The answer to that is yes and no, as long as they're small enough. By now, Pico W has been out for a while. Maybe someone's done a more full-fat web server, which will work in a better way. Maybe ported a web server from another Python implementation, which works better. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe if you'd like to see more, and bye.